Hello and welcome to another edition of This Week in Jewish History. This week in November happens to coincide with the anniversary of a terrible event in Polish Jewish history, the burning of the Talmud in the wake of the Frankist disputation. So we'll talk a little bit about Jacob Frank and his movement and how it came to attack the Talmud specifically, and give you a sense of this very sad and unusual chapter in Jewish history. Jacob Frank was born to a middle-class Jewish family in Poland in 1726. His family, like many middle-class families of that era, were secretly worshippers of Sabbatai Tzvi, who in the 17th century had created a tremendous uprising in the Jewish world by proclaiming himself as the Messiah. His particular story ended very badly, as he ultimately converted to Islam, but many of his followers were really quite active still well into the 18th century, both in Eastern Europe and also throughout the Mediterranean basin. Many of them even followed him into apostasy to Islam and became a movement known as the Dunme. Jacob Frank, our subject, actually traveled to Smyrna and a few other places where there were large numbers of Sabbateans, and he was highly influenced by their teachings. Frank came back to Poland after actually a conversion to Islam as well, and gathered around him a large group of followers who were very interested in his charismatic leadership. In particular, he promoted an idea of purification through transgression, or avera lishma, a sin for the right reasons, as it were, and his movement was reputed to not only be involved in public desecration of the Sabbath and things like that, but even wild orgiastic rituals that were looked on with high levels of disfavor by the rabbis. He was denounced to the non-Jewish leadership of Poland, but his movement found a rather interesting sort of strategy to counter the attacks of the traditionalist communities. They argued that, in fact, they were not Talmudic Jews, they were Zoharistic Jews, meaning they were Kabbalistic Jews, and in fact the Kabbalah taught doctrines which are much closer to Christianity, in particular the idea of the Trinity. As a result, the church actually took Frank and his followers under their protection. In particular, a Bishop Dembowski of Poland argued that, in fact, the Frankists and their opponents should have a major disputation over the Talmud. This occurred in 1757, as the Frankists disputed with the Talmud, with the traditionalist community, over the role of the Talmud. The dispute was quite intense, but as these things often happen, ultimately the church decided in favor of the Frankists, and the Talmud was ordered burned in Poland. Some 10,000 volumes of Talmud were collected, a tremendous loss to the libraries of the Jews of that era. Frank ultimately led a very checkered career afterwards, converting to Christianity and attracting even more followers in his now third religion. He made something of a career of it, but he got into trouble with the authorities because of his ongoing antinomian activities. Ultimately, he was imprisoned for a while. He carried himself as a noble, but when he died, he had a very large retinue, as you see in this contemporary depiction of his deathbed. The movement did continue under his daughter, Eve, and traces of it lingered well into the early 19th century. The long-lasting impact for the Jews, however, was the devastating attack on the Talmud, once again, resulting in a huge loss not only of the human capital of many Jews who actually were attracted to Frank's movement, but also of the destruction of many precious volumes which were lost forever. Well, that's it for this week. I hope you have an excellent week, and I look forward to speaking with you again.